Let's make a Christmas countdown calendar. And you know what? At the end, we can make a full year calendar as well. But let's start with this. We're going to have the current month, and we're going to have December displayed. A little graph down here showing the time elapsed since the beginning of the year till Christmas. We're 87% of the way there as of today, which is November the 10th. And we've got 45 days to go. All right, let's build this. First thing I like to do, let's just select everything. Let's grab a nice font. And let me know in the comments if you'd like to see how I got Google Sans font, which is a proprietary font, into my Google Sheet, because it doesn't come out of the gate. Let's resize some of this stuff. And then, let's do this one. Make those a little bit narrower. And we can't merge across a range, or we can't center across a range in Google Sheets, unfortunately. So we're just going to use the merge and center functions. It's not ideal, I know, but it's what we've got to work with. So I like to get my format of everything squared away at the onset here. And in fact, let's throw in a border, shall we, on everything here. Copy that over here. And now we've got our 2 months calendar range. So this is going to be the current month, and then this is going to be December of the current year. Now, the first piece of information we want to know is days till Christmas, right? And let's text wrap that, center it up. And to get days till Christmas, we just need to subtract today's date from December 25th. So let's do it like this. Let's say date, and then we can say the year. Well, we want that to be today's year. And then the month and the day is December 25th. And then we want to subtract today from that. Okay? Boom. We got 45 days till Christmas. All right. Let's make that a little bit bigger. And suppose you want to know like weeks and days. Well, we can do something a little bit fancy here, too. We can say for the weeks, it's not fancy at all, just do that divided by 7, right? Well, we don't need a decimal, so we can say floor that divided by 7, and we got 6 weeks to go, right? Okay, what about the days? Well, we can do J3. Actually, we can do mod J3, 7. So that's the remainder of 45 divided by 7. So 3 days, 6 weeks, and 3 days. Now, if you want, check this out. We can actually write some stuff in parentheses, and we can go, hey, this is also the same as J3 divided by 7. Oh, I didn't do the floor part again. Floor J3 divided by 7. So 6. And weeks and ampersand. And then we can say mod J3, 7, 3 days. So that's a handy way if you ever need to combine strings that you're writing in with formulas that you want to fill those strings into. All right, so I'm actually going to just take this out and move this, and then cut and paste that so it's right under there. Okay, tell you what, let's go ahead and give ourselves a nice little border here, and we can do it like so. And then this middle guy right here, I just want that to pop a little bit, so we're going to change the font and everything. So now we know 45 days till Christmas. All right, let's populate these calendars. So this is the fun part. This is just going to be the first, or this is going to be the month that today is in, right? And we actually want to pull the first day of the month. So let's do that year, or that date year trick. The year will be year today. The month will be month today. And then the day will be 1. So that's, in my case right now, November the 1st. All right, to populate this calendar, we're going to use the weekday function. Now, weekday just gives us a numeric value for the weekdays. And if we give it November the 1st, that's a Wednesday, and so it's going to say 4, because it starts, normally it starts with Sunday being 1, Monday 2, Tuesday 3, and so forth. This doesn't belong right here. This belongs over here, because this would be Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, right? So how are we going to populate this guy? Well, let's just use math. 4 minus what is 1? 3. Because this is Sunday, it needs to be weekday 1. So what we're going to do is we're going to do an if statement. So if weekday of this is 1, then we just need to put it there, because that would be Sunday, the first day of the month. But if it's not, then we need to take this day, which is 4, and we need to subtract 3 from it. So the way we dynamically get the numerical value 3 to subtract 3 days from the date is to say minus weekday of that day minus 1. And that gives us October the 29th. All right, so that's the only like real formula we need here, because once we have that, we can just say equals this plus 1. And drag that all the way over. Then for this bottom line, we can say equals that plus 1. And from there, we now can just populate, the whole November calendar. So this isn't super helpful yet because it's not very legible, but let's do a few things to it, center it up, and then we can change the format. And before we do that, let's go ahead and fix our header lines. We're going to say weekday of this, drag that over, center those up as well. And now let's change the format of everything that we see here. So this top, we just want it to say November, right? So we come down here to date and time, we get rid of the date, and we say, hey, I want this to be the month, and I want it to be the full name, apply. For the header row, we do the same thing, only I want that to be Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, etc., just the abbreviations. And then down here, I want this to be this right here, the actual numeric value with a leading zero in the case of these single digit days. Okay, let's go one further and just make this big and bold. And same thing with our text here, make it a little bit bigger and bolder. All right, and already you can see another problem. We need some way to distinguish the days of November between the days of October and then the days of December down here, because we've populated the entire 6 rows, but we don't really want these to look like they're the same as our November days. So let's use some conditional formatting, and that is going to be right here. And what we're going to say is we're going to use a custom formula because we want this to be equals the month of B2. And actually, I want to hold that in place. So B2 does not equal to the month of B4. And check that out. All right, so I just want to like pretty much gray these out. Background like this. I guess we want it to be so you can kind of see the letters or the numbers. I like that. And actually, I'm going to change one more thing. I just want the background to be white and the numbers to be grayed out. Now, the next item we want to do is also with conditional formatting. And we have some built-in date functions here. We can just say, hey, date is before today. And if it is, I want to cross through that number, and then we can just make it, green like that. Boom. So now we've got the days that have already happened in November crossed out, and let's do one more thing, add another rule, make sure we've selected all of our month days. If today is exactly today, let's just make it big and green and then white font. So that's today's date. Now we've got this month's calendar. What about next month's calendar? We could just manually plug it in. We could say date, year, today, And then the month is 12. Whoops. And the date is the first. So that gives us that. Oh, we probably should have copied our formatting over here, but we did not. Now, same thing here. I want to bring in, let's just say, weekdays there. That's going to be the same. And then this is going to be the same formula, only we're going to be using L2. One other thing you may have guessed for December, let's go ahead and add if date is exactly year to day, 1225. There it is. Then we'll turn that just bright red, right? And actually, the only thing we actually need over here is just in the event that this is in December, let's also give ourselves the conditional formatting here. Date is exactly 1225. That'll ensure that if we're in December currently, we'll still highlight Christmas Day with red. Let's do one more thing. We're going to do a spark graph or a spark chart down here. I'm going to center this up or merge and center that. And we're going to use this sparkline function. We're going to take data and then give it some options to create a little bar chart down here. But before we actually make it, let's get our data right in here. And this data is going to be year frac. So this is the fraction of the year between two dates. So the start date is today, and then the end date is date. Same thing we just did. Year today, month 12, day 25, and that'll give us, actually we need to do 1 minus year frac, that'll give us 87.5%. So we're 87.5% to Christmas as of today at the recording of this video. Whoops, I'm going to make that bold. I'm actually going to make it red. I don't know why it's not saving this hex code that I keep using, but it's not. And make that white. Okay. Now, for this sparkline chart, we're going to take that data, which looks like it's in J10, and then we're going to give it options. You do these curly braces for the options, and you say chart type, quote, comma, bar. Then you do a semicolon if you want another option, and I'm going to do max, because the maximum for the chart is going to be 1, which is 100%. Then I'm going to do another comma, and I'm going to say color 1, and that's going to be equal to this hex code that I keep using, this red code. And it's giving me an error because I need to do a semicolon right there. And there we go. And as you can see, it goes 87.5% of the way all the way to the end here. Let's put a red border around it so you can more easily see that. There's that red again. And there we go. So we're 87.5% of the way to Christmas. Last two things we'll do. I'm going to turn off the grid lines just because it looks better without them. Have I already deleted? Nope. I'm going to delete all this stuff down here because it gives me 1,000 rows that I don't need. And then, just because, let's go to settings, calculation. And this is going to, it's usually on change. This affects how often now, today, rand, and ran between are updated. So we're using today. If we never change anything in here, then it's never going to update. So I want it to actually update every hour because we're just calculating the days. If we wanted to update every minute, if we were calculating minutes, we could, but I'm not in this sheet. Save that. So now these functions that are using today will update at least every hour or whenever I change the spreadsheet. Okay. Now let's make a full year chart like this. And it's pretty simple. It's the same stuff that we just learned. Only difference being, let's come over here, take off this conditional formatting. We'll do all that on our own for this one in a minute. Oh, I still got something on there. Remove that. And the only difference is going to be now we want this to be January 1. So the year is right, the month is not right. So I'm just going to go month, January, and there we go. Okay, let's just for readability's sake, let's drag this stuff up here. Make that like that. And I'm going to have February here. And I'm actually going to have three across just so it's a little bit easier to work with. I'm going to zoom out for a moment. And yeah, that looks good to me. Let's make these a little bit closer together just so we can deal with them a little bit more easily. Now we got January, February, March. All right. Well, let's see here. This needs to be just 1 month ahead of this. So let's change these top formulas. To do that, we can use this sweet little function called Edate. That gives us a start date, which is over here, January 1, and how many months forward we want to go. We want to go exactly 1 month forward. So that was pretty easy. Now we got January, February, March. Copy all this stuff. And right below here, the only thing we'll need to change is Edate for this. Now needs to reference this one, April, May, June, and my friends, we're good to go. Copy this down, and there we are. There's our full year. All right, now for some conditional formatting. We can do all these in one fell swoop. So let's use that same month is not formula. So we go month of B4. Which is January 1st, is not equal to month of, well, we can't use B2 because we want it to copy over. So let's use B6 because B6, and we're going to hold the 6 in place, this will always be in the current month. So same with J6, this 2 weeks after that first square will always be in the first month. All right, let's make it like this. And so now we've got that. And we can do that same thing down here on each quarter. Now that we've got that, we can then in one fell swoop, I'm going to zoom out just a moment so I can more easily grab all this stuff, grab all the days in the whole year, add this, go to our date rules, date is before today, and if it is, let's cross those out. I don't know. Let's just use this and this. And there we go. We've got our entire year marked off anything that is before today. Hope that was helpful for you and you enjoyed making our Christmas countdown especially. Please click like and subscribe to my videos if it was. Hope you have a great day. Bye.